Previously on Alan Wake, Alice has been kidnapped.
Alan, please help me.
Alice?
You'll do exactly what I say if you ever want to see your wife again.
I can't tell anyone except my agent, Barry.
Damn it, Barry, they'll kill her.
You're my best friend, and I'm worried that you're not right in the head.
The ransom is a manuscript I supposedly wrote that's coming true before my eyes.
It happened just the way it was on that page. So dark.
I have found only a few scattered pages.
I want the entire manuscript.
The deadline is in 2 days.
I found Mr. Wake's pages.
Good girl.
How the hell did she get her hands on the manuscript anyway?
I don't know. She's resourceful. I told you you were too hard on her.
Listen, I found out all sorts of interesting stuff while I was digging around.
Yeah.
Mr. Wake, it's Sheriff Breaker. We have an FBI agent here, Agent Nightingale.
FBI?
He's anxious to see you. You'd better come to the station.
Okay, I'll be right over, Sheriff. Let's make this quick, huh?
Help you folks? Name's Randolph. I'm the manager.
We're looking for Rose. Works as a waitress down at the diner.
Rose, sure. Nice girl. Who wants to know?
I'm Alan Wake.
The writer, huh? I heard on the radio you were visiting. Well, I'll show you her trailer. That Rose, she's a nice girl. Always pays her rent on time.
As I was saying, Al, I found all sorts of weird stuff from the local newspaper's archives. This place is crazy. Disappearances, mysterious deaths, urban legends come true, and get this, most of this stuff takes place around Cauldron Lake.
Well, you ain't wrong, mister. The Indians thought the lake was a doorway to the underworld. I'm the God-fearing type myself. I don't hold with that sort of thing.
Yeah, okay. Anyway, there was an island there owned by a guy called Thomas Zane. Now, some of the articles I found about him make him out to be a famous writer. But I ran a bunch of searches, couldn't find a single thing he wrote. Zane was heavily into diving, so much so that the place came to be called Diver's Isle. But the volcano under the lake erupted in 1970, and Zane went down with the island.
Yeah, how about that? It was there in the morning, as if it had fallen from the sky. But it would take a tornado to lift something like that. We're damn lucky it didn't crush any of the trailers. Come on, mister. I'll take you to Rose's trailer.
Gets better. A local girl, Barbara Jagger, drowned in Cauldron Lake just a week earlier. They were lovers.
Sure, Jagger's a local spook story. The scratching hag comes for you in the dark. Childish stuff like that.
Anyway, Al, I'm just getting to the best part. All of the articles about this stuff were written by Cynthia Weaver. I asked around, and she's that crazy bag lady you met.
What, the lamp lady? She can be a little loopy, but she's not homeless or anything.
Yeah, anyway, she knew both Jagger and Zane before they both died, and she had some kind of a breakdown.
Well, mister, this here's Rose's trailer. You mind me asking what you want with her?
We're just here to talk to her, pal.
come to... Oh dear, Mr. Wake. I'm so glad you're here.
Rose, you have my manuscript?
Oh yes. Yes. Please, come in.
Hey, this is really good!
Rose.
Yes?
My manuscript. I really need it.
I understand. I know what you need. A muse to inspire you.
Oh, for Barry? She doesn't have anything.
Yeah, hey, Al? Al, what's... Oh...
Barry! What?
It's coming for you, hiding in my barber's skin. I'm too weak to stop it. You must turn the lights on.
I promised I'd come visit you and your lovely wife. You must finish what you started. I insist.
You must turn the lights on. Turn the light on.
Back to work, boy.
I felt nauseous, hungover. Only anger kept me going.
I can't tell reality from dream anymore, but it seems I have an imaginary editor to help me.
Rose She's took a day from me. I had less than 12 hours left to meet the kidnapper. All I could do was get Barry into the car, work something out once I got on the road.
Welcome to the Oh Dear Diner. What can I get you today? Coffee?
I couldn't work up much hate for Rose. Something had used her to get to me, and left its mark. My gun and flashlight were gone. I'd have to find a way to get Barry into the car as quickly as possible. There was no time to waste.
I just stepped outside to catch a breath of fresh air. Let me tell you, the weather's getting heavy. Nights like this make me especially glad I'm here.
Oh, you're gonna get it now. God knows what you've done to that poor girl.
This is Agent Nightingale, FBI! Get him up, Hemingway! You're under arrest! You move a muscle, I'll unload right in your goddamn face! Stay right where you are, Slade!
Right here, you goddamn maniac!
I hated to leave Barry behind, but there was no way I'd miss my appointment with the kidnapper.
Give it up, Mr. Wake! Come on! Make it easier!
Come on! lost contact with the person that you assigned to me. Explain to me.
This horror was everywhere I went, circling me. The cops didn't stand a chance. They were after a writer, not a monster. I imagined that the broadcast tower in the distance was part of the local radio station. Maine seemed like a decent guy. Perhaps he could give me directions to the coal mine. Unnatural shadows clung to the gate. The darkness that was after me was trying to stop me. I wouldn't get through without a light. Generator conked out. I'd have to see if I could fix it and try again. It took me a moment to recognize the flashback grenades. They were an ideal weapon for my situation.
Team 1, come in. Over. Team 1, this is Sheriff Breaker.
Thank you.
And here's another call. You're on KBFFM with Pat Main.
It's Milk Peabody, Pat.
What's on your mind, Mel?
Give it your flows, Ralph. You are my nervous.
I hope Maine could lend me a car to get to the coal mine.
Come on in, Mr. Wake.
Oh, I'm so glad you could find the time to do this, Mr. Wake.
Nowhere to run now, Dan Brown. You back away from me. Don't hurt.
Whoa. Everyone calm down. Put the gun down. We're all friends here, right?
Cool your jets, Nightingale. We got him.
Jesus, priest!
What the hell's the matter with you? There's a civilian in there.
I had fallen off so many cliffs it was ridiculous. That's what you get for naming a book The Sudden Stop. It was probably good I hadn't had the chance to tell Maine where I was going. I'd have to lose the cops and find my own way to the mine.
Thank you.
There was no sensible reason for the power company work lights to be here. It was almost as if they'd been left for someone like me to use.
Hello?
The most stubborn man I've ever met.
Alice? Alice?
Alan. I'm so afraid. It keeps me in the dark. Please help me. I look at you, Alan, and it's not you. Something else. Looking out from behind your eyes.
Alice, I'm here.
The connection had been terrible, but that wasn't the only thing that hadn't been right with the call. She sounded wrong somehow, but she had called me. I could see a railway bridge up ahead, and a warehouse of some sort on the opposite shore. I hoped I could find a car from there. That was pursuing me it was taking over. It can't be in his power. As a teenager, just started to get interested in writing, Stephen King had been a source of inspiration to me. I thought about all the inanimate objects that had come to life in his books. No one is safe in a good horror story, certainly not the protagonist. That's what makes them fun. This was anything but. The darkness could possess anything, and it was getting closer. never been this glad to see the sunrise. I had a couple of hours to get to the coal mine. The coal mine wasn't far now. Today, I would meet the kidnapper, and he would give me Alice. I wouldn't give him any other choice. A drowning man will clutch at a straw. Little by little, without realizing it, I'd come to believe that the story in the manuscript was coming true. The current of its narrative had taken me deeper and deeper into dark waters. Alice had been taken from me. Barry was probably in jail. I was a fugitive from the FBI. The whole world taken over by the Dark Presence was trying to destroy me. It all felt real, but it matched a textbook case of insanity. It was early. I was supposed to meet the kidnapper at noon in the main building. The coal mine was quiet. It was a museum now. I didn't want to go outside. Cops had to be looking for me. The noon sun turned the place into a sauna. The day dragged on. Different scenarios ran through my mind. Ways of how I'd torture the kidnapper to get Alice back, or the different horrible things he could have done to her. I imagined her dead. I had no way of knowing she was still alive. It was killing me. I was running on blind hope. It was all a waste of time. The bastard never showed up.
are you?
Change of plans. You know where Mirror Peak is? It's a big mountain north of where you are. You follow the path from the mine, you can't miss it. There's a lookout point there. I'll be waiting.
I'm through being jerked around by you.
You wanna see your wife alive? Cause if you do, you better watch what you say to me. Do we understand each other?
I wanna talk to Alice.
Yeah, and I want the manuscript. Don't keep me waiting, Wake.
Hello? Hello!
I'm gonna kill him!
I had to get to Mirror Peak. It was close. Maybe closer than ever before. The hillside ahead was to go through the building. I had to find a way to avoid electrocution.
There was no way the flashbang grenades were standard power company equipment. I had no real plan. I was going to give the kidnapper all the manuscript pages I had for Alice. If that wasn't enough, I'd hold him at gunpoint and make him talk.
The dark presence was moving ahead of me in the same direction I was going. A cold feeling settled itself in the pit of my stomach. Was it going for Alice?
The graveyard shift may cause cancer.
The place was dead, a ghost town. Had been for decades, maybe a century.
outside of riding is a struggle. I feel ill. I managed to make my way downstairs. There's a shoebox filled with books and papers by Thomas Zane. It's very hard to focus, but I managed to read some of it. He's a poet, and a good one. He writes of muses and creators summoning fabulous things from the past. The kidnapper had sent me a text. The message was full of spelling errors and insults. It was telling me to hurry up. Birds. Without warning, the headache stabbed at my brain.
I'd have to make my way up this mineshaft in order to go on. Maybe the machinery could help me with that.
I could see Cauldron Lake. I thought I could make out the spot where the island and the cabin had been. There was a light near it. It had to be a boat. I was close now. I had to get there fast. I dreaded what I would find.
Wait! Are you? Wait!
Hey, I'm here! I'm coming!
No! Get away! Sorry! Please, wait! The boss didn't know who he was messing with! I didn't know! I swear, I didn't know!
We don't have a wife! We don't know where she is! She's probably drowned! We just said we had her to make a...
Oh!